Today we look into creating cut lists and cut diagrams from a FreeCAD model. Before getting started, we have to install the A2 Plus workbench by going to Tools, Add-ons, then select the workbench and install it. After installing the workbench, go to the website link in the description and follow the instructions to modify a few files. The files from the A2 Plus workbench are in the following folders: for Windows, in C, User, Username, App Data, Roaming, FreeCAD, Mod, A2 Plus, and for Linux in the home directory, .freecad, mod, A2 Plus. Replace the content of the file a2p_partlist_globals.py in this folder with the one downloaded from the website. Then copy the text from the gray box on the website and look in the same folder in the file a2p_bom.py for the text that starts with last entry of part informations. This should be around line 113. Then insert the text after the two lines and save the file. After restarting FreeCAD, we are good to open the Japanese toolbox from the last part of the tutorial. After all this preparation work, the creation of the cut list is actually quite simple. Just click on this button and the part list is created as a new spreadsheet. We open this spreadsheet and export it as a CSV file. Download the spreadsheet from the resource section of the website and open it with the application of your choice. Here we use LibreOffice, but Excel or Google Docs should also work fine. Open the CSV file and copy the data from the file into the spreadsheet in the table Input and overwrite the sample data. In the table Calculations, we can check if there are any warnings. In our case, there's one warning that Cut Micro can't cope with float numbers. So let's go back to the input sheet and round this number. Let's now have a look at the three output tabs. The spreadsheet contains three output formats for three different tools. The first one is cutlistoptimizer.com. It's a software that is, as of now, free to use, but it is not open source, so the conditions for its usage might change in the future. Go to the respective tab and save a copy as a CSV file. Make sure you select the Edit Filter Setting checkbox and that the items are separated by comma. Open the file in a text editor and remove the empty lines. On cutlistoptimizer.com, we create a few panels that we have in stock. Next, we import the CSV file and hit the Calculate button. After the calculation is done, we can export the file as PDF, print it, and take it to the table saw. Cutlist Optimizer is great, but as the website could go down or start to charge money for their service, let's now look at two alternative solutions. UpCut is open source software. We export the CSV file for UpCut by separating the entries with a semicolon. Again, we delete the empty lines in the text editor. UpCut is available at upcut.herukuapp.com. Its interface is not as nice as the one from Cutlist Optimizer, but it gets the job done. We again create two panels and then import the CSV file. After hitting the calculate button, we can take a look at the result and export the PDF. The last tab is for Cut Micro. We save this tab as CSV. The delimiter doesn't matter, but the string delimiter is important. After saving the file, the file extension has to be changed from CSV to CPXML. In Cut Micro, we open the XML file and create two new panels. After hitting the play button, we go to the Design tab. Now select Tool Auto Place to automatically place the pieces onto the panels. The nice thing about Cut Micro is that you can interactively rearrange the panels. Under Linux, the export and print functions are not working, but taking a screenshot works quite well. All these methods are optimized for using the table saw. If you are looking for a way to use the CNC or the laser cutter, the process is slightly different. In the laser cut interlocking workbench, we place all the pieces flat side by side. Each shape is then exported as a DXF file. We import these files in deepnest.io. The software optimizes their placement and we export the resulting file as SVG. The only downside of this tool is that the resulting cut diagrams can't be cut on a table saw, as you can't run a cut across the sheet. But for the laser, it's perfect. Hopefully this video helps you to get more out of FreeCAD. If you know of other solutions for managing cut lists, or if there are any other topics you want me to cover in future videos, please leave a comment. And don't forget to subscribe for more FreeCAD videos.